There are real fears that Canada's overheated housing market is about to cool fast, especially the condo market. It's a situation that has Canada's top banker and finance minister sounding more alarmed than ever. Ron Charles takes a closer look for us tonight.
And let's go into the bedroom.
A two-bedroom condo with an asking price of $820,000 doesn't much faze Mike Shembri.
You kind of worry that it's getting a little bit too high, but it keeps going up and up and up, so you might as well kind of just buy in, is my thought on it.
That attitude, along with record low interest rates, may be what's fueling this, an unprecedented and seemingly unending condo building boom.
We have a strong demand, and it's because I think Toronto's becoming a real world-class city. We've got the Pan Am Games coming in 2015 that's going to bring a lot more focus as well.
In spite of that optimism, what's been happening here and in a couple of other Canadian housing markets has alarmed some economists and decision makers.
Condo construction was up in the GTA 40% year over year. That's not a sustainable rate of construction.
I particularly watch the condo market in Vancouver, Toronto, and to some extent in Montreal as well.
There are issues in, particularly in some parts of the country, in the condo market, without question, where activity has been particularly strong, has reached back to levels of the late 1980s.
Back in the late 1980s, a housing bubble burst, sending prices plummeting by 40%. In Vancouver, prices have already started to fall, but just slightly.
The prices have come off here on certain product, but still a pretty healthy market overall.
And in Toronto, the buyers are still showing up, and so the buildings are still going up. Ron Charles, CBC News, Toronto.